Good morning, PAW staff, clients, friends joining us for Wednesday's class. Welcome. We had a pretty fun time, I think, looking at George Antheil's music yesterday, the great American composer. As I was listening to it, he sounds a lot like Leonard Bernstein. Leonard Bernstein would take some of those rhythms, percussive rhythms, and really do them beautifully and brilliantly well, like in West Side Story with those arrangements. So it was just an afterthought I was thinking about yesterday afternoon. So yeah, George Antheil. And then your results are in for Phantom Thread for film scoring. So we're going to see those on Friday. Can't wait to share that with you. Good job. Good job. Today we're going to look at a really groovy band that it sounds like if you were to take the 60s, you know, the easy listening part of the 1960s and kind of put that in a time capsule and have a group, a pop group from England, reinterpret, reimagine, reinvent all of these sounds into something truly original. That's what you're going to get. Today we're going to be looking at the group, the High Llamas.
From high to low, the valley's deep, the village sleeps. High to low, the valley goes. From high to low, from high to low.
So Sean O'Hagan is basically the High Llamas. I mean, they started in 1991. So this music sounds old, but also fresh. I mean, probably because their influences still live on, and they make they don't hide their influences a lot. Sean O'Hagan is very vocal about how deeply influenced he was by the Beach Boys. So when we're hearing this, it's almost like if you were to freeze frame the late Beach Boys, Brian Wilson stuff with Van Dyke Parks, you know, around Pet Sounds, and after that, they're taking that sound and they're writing their own songs. It's really beautiful arrangements. Strings, brass. They should be more famous. Hopefully we're going to give them a little bit more cred, because it's such beautiful, great, easy listening music that's really original. Let's go over to England. This is where they start, and Sean O'Hagan, the first album that he makes, he's originally right before this, he was with Micro Disney. And then he originally came up with this sound that was very influenced by Beach Boys, Steve Reich even, Burt Bacharach, Herb Alpert, Bossa Nova, Ennio Morricone. All of these people, we know these people because we've done classes on them. This sound is so fresh, and what's interesting is that it's such a Southern California sound. It's, you know, because the Beach Boys were, you know, from Hawthorne, and they encapsulated that surf sound so well. And then Brian Wilson kind of, you know, transcended that with Van Dyke Parks. And the High Llamas just fell in love with that kind of Southern California feeling of music. So this is interesting. They're a pop, avant-garde pop band, but they're highly melodic, and they've just taken from so many different bands and places around the world, and I just think it's wonderful.
Change.
The name came from a picture of a Victorian era hot air balloon. That's where the High Llamas got their name. The first album was called the High Llamas, and then he just decided, that'll be the band name. What we're hearing is very perfectly orchestrated. We're hearing horns and strings orchestrated in a way that's not classical sounding per se. I mean, there's Henry Mancini influences. There's a lot of, it's kind of like, it's hard to classify. It's very, I just kind of wanted to share, and this is just going to be a relaxing class because I just wanted to share some of my favorite songs that they've done. What's amazing is that Sean O'Hagan and the High Llamas were able to really incorporate all these different kinds of music into something, but something original. I mean, this sounds very, especially, I mean, for this English group in the 90s to be doing this, we've seen what kind of music is, I mean, we looked at Beck last week, and Beck, you know, there's a little bit of Beck maybe in this, but Beck was influenced by, you know, folk music and hip hop, right? These guys are writing Southern California surf-like beautiful music in England in the 90s. Take care to avoid the heavy stuff. So different, so fresh. They're just doing exactly what they want to do. They're writing songs and lyrics and arrangements. What's really important are the arrangements in this. Like, they'll be doing a pop song and then they'll kind of do something like this in the middle of it. Beautiful, right? I mean, they'll go into waltzes, they'll change time signatures. I think, with the 40s and 50s, you had big band music, and then rock and roll, early rock and roll, we looked at Little Richard. Those are all, you know, 3-4 chord songs, mostly all in 4-4 time signature, right? Nothing wrong with that. With groups like the Beatles and the Beach Boys and other stuff, people get a little bit more adventurous with, thanks to George Martin, thanks to Phil Spector, they get a little bit more influenced by kind of changing up the time signatures, changing up the just regular orchestrations of all the strings doing the same thing. High Llamas are experimenting with time signature changes in a way that's still very musical. That's why I don't want to get super technical, because I really want you to just listen and enjoy the music. Patiently waiting this silence to give songs in the making from these walls a tune for. And so they're kind of taking all these complex time signatures, complex key changes, complex arrangements into making it not sound complex, into making it sound really just lively, magical, creative, gentle, and sunny, right? I mean, it feels kind of like sunshine sometimes. So that's just a small taste of the High Llamas. Check them out. Wonderful group. Sean O'Hagan, very influential, very masterful, colorful arranger, colorful orchestrator. And they just take from the best. I mean, I think that's what's so great about art, is that artists, you try to take from your favorites and take from the best and then try to make it your own. And they definitely made it their own with their own songs, their own arrangements, orchestrations, just their own color. It's just so magical. So hope you enjoy the High Llamas, brief little taste of them, and I'll see you tomorrow for our little LA tour. Okay, have a great rest of the day. Love you and miss you.